Well, with the opening of a new 320,000 square foot building in Oklahoma City, the Boeing company is preparing to more than double its workforce in Oklahoma. More than 2,100 jobs are coming to the state, according to the company's CEO, because of Oklahoma's reputation for top-end, affordable engineers. But maintaining a well-skilled workforce is an investment, which is where our Alisa Hines picks up our story.
That's right, Rob. Across the aerospace industry, companies are in search of high-skilled, well-trained employees, which is why Boeing hosted a group of Oklahoma educators. To help give them some insight into the importance of piquing students' interest in aviation at an early age. With a presence in Oklahoma since 1953, engineers at Boeing have been supporting Tinker Air Force Base and the missions they do for our country.
We provide engineering solutions for the sustainment of the aircraft and weapon systems that the Tinker Air Force Base supports.
Michael Emmelhaines is the site director at Boeing and says engineering talent is key to their success, but not always easy to find.
As the global economy expands, the ability to have that engineering talent gets to be more and more of a challenge. We're expanding in Oklahoma City. We're actually going to double in size over the next 2 years. And as we do that, it's going to drive more and more requirements for engineering talent. Certainly, we get a pretty good supply from the regional universities, OU, OSU, and that certainly is a huge benefit to what we need. I want to be here another 50 or 100 years, so we need a pipeline of engineering and math students to help fill that need as we go forward.
So they're helping build their own pipeline.
We were honored this year to get to host the Education Day portion of the Oklahoma Aerospace Summit, and it's a very, very important event. It's one where teachers throughout the state are invited. They come and they sit through some workshops and learn more and more about STEM education, the aerospace industry, how we can partner and support them. So it's a great opportunity for them to spend some time with leadership in the aerospace community and understand it a little bit better. But it's just a wonderful way also for us to thank them for what they do to help ensure the education of our young people.
According to retired Brigadier General Ben Robinson, there's a shortage of engineers in aerospace, and it takes a long time to train someone, so we need to start early.
It's important not just in Oklahoma, but across America. We have got to improve our science, technology, engineering, and math if we want to get from where we are right now in 17th in the world in engineering back to the top. That's the way we're going to create jobs, because we're going to bring engineering back from offshore, back to America. This is where it starts. An engineer starts in middle school, and it's a decade and a half long process, but it starts in middle school. We've got to start making those connections now and firing up and creating that enthusiasm, that creativity, that ingenuity in our middle school students, and they will produce engineers in the future. So this is a paying it forward to our future.
Do we still see evidence of those impacts today?
So how do you get students excited about such a challenging field? Dorinda Risenhoover is with the Oklahoma NASA Space Grant Consortium.
Kids don't realize it, but they're born as scientists. You know, when they're little babies, they're little natural scientists. And somewhere along the way, they decide, and it's mostly girls, but even some of the boys decide that they may not be so good at science, and they don't realize that it's just what they've been doing all their entire life. And so activities like this remind them that anyone can be a scientist and that they are scientists every single day.
But before you can teach the student,
I have them come up first with how could they make it move with just the rocket?
You have to teach the teacher.
Well, the biggest thing is, especially right now with a huge push of STEM education, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, that they need real-life hands-on activities that they can do with their students that are simple enough and applicable enough back to the classroom and cheap. And the activities that I'm doing with them, which are very consistent with a lot of NASA activities, they are using recycled materials or using very cheap materials. So the teachers can easily implement these in their classroom. And it's a real working model that allows the children to really discover the concept without being told the concept.
Kelly Wardlaw is a Stillwater Middle School teacher and says it's hands-on instruction.
Anytime you can put something in their hands and get them playing, then they're learning, and they don't know it, and they love it.
Just looking at how much fun these teachers are having, I'd say their students are in for a really fun school year.
Oh, they would love it. Absolutely. Anytime you give them a chance to work, they're probably better with glue sticks than we are.
They always learn. Every time you give them something to do, they're always learning something.
Even after-school programs are getting involved. Cedric Currin-Moore is the STEM project coordinator for the Oklahoma After School Network and says these activities help connect education to the real world.
And it shows not only teachers but students how important science is, math is, and how, you know, it connects to the aerospace industry and other industries.
This program has even caught the eye of the director of the National Career Pathways Network, David Bond.
This is extremely important. I'm very impressed with what's going on here. The teachers are learning ways to show students how what they're learning in the classroom is used in the real world, and that's just a perfect way to learn.
A learning experience for teachers to take back to the classroom and make future engineers. Now, while many of the jobs coming into the state may be filled with Boeing workers from Wichita and the West Coast, Boeing officials know that for the long-term viability of their company, they need to be able to produce homegrown engineering talent.
Now, I want to ask you about something General Ben Robinson said. Does it really take 18 years to educate an engineer?
You heard right, Rob. STEM classes tend to build upon themselves, and STEM advocates seem to think that to get kids interested in these fields, they need to get to them before they hit high school. Because once they hit high school, they seem to think taking these kind of classes is just way too hard.
Pretty interesting. Good story. Thank you so much, Alisa.
You're welcome, Rob.
Now, when we return, we'll take a look at why the next big thing in aviation may be very, very small.